Good morning, welcome back. Hope your Tuesday is going good. Today I've decided to go ahead and open up the last, I think we have three packs left of the 2016 Certified. No, we have five packs. 10 packs in a hobby box. Forgot about that. I was thinking of the Torque hobby box that we recently opened up and finished. So we still have a Donruss Blaster box, a Topps Gypsy Queen box, and of course four more installments of the Masters of Racing set to go. Looks like we have a thick pack, a medium-sized pack, and three really thin packs. So hopefully we'll get some good stuff. Of course, 2016 Certified has this beautiful wrapper. Very, very, I say generic, but generic's not a good word. I guess indescript might be better. Does have the 2016, the year on it. There you see the print runs on these cards. The reason I like these particular packs so much, there's no driver or car on it to really date it outside of the year. If the 2016 wasn't on there, you could literally say that this pack come from any year unless you knew the color code or color combinations. These are somewhat reflective, high-quality cards, as you can see, and unfortunately, because it is bright in here, the camera is going to not function as well as I want it to. So we're going to start off with Jimmy Johnson. Move to Daniel Hemric. Big news on him. He's moving to Colleg Racing next year after a year, excuse me, Joe Gibbs. Daniel Suarez, of course, he will be at Trackhouse again next year. They should have some good runs. Nicole Behar, not sure, I don't know a lot about her. Maybe somebody else does. And Clint Boyer, he should return to the Fox booth. Did pretty good up there this year. Of course, he debuted last year. Well, he probably debuted a few years ago, but really made a splash last year during the NASCAR iRacing series, during that little shutdown that we had. Go to pack number two. Going to start off with an Immortals of David Pearson. Nice looking card there. Reed Sorensen. I believe he's still kind of, he races from time to time, but he's mostly a spotter for, I want to say, Rick Ware Racing. Of course, Rick Ware Racing absorbed Premium Motorsports that Reed is seen here with a uniform of. We have a numbered card, an Epics of Mark Martin, numbered 20 of 199. Of course, this is during Mark's days with Roush Racing. We have an Immortals, Ned Jarrett. Two-time NASCAR champion, 1961 and 1965. And A.J. Allmendinger, who's my best guess, he's going to be in the final four drivers that make the Xfinity Series playoffs this year. Of course, he does have a Cup Series win at the road course in Indianapolis. I was in attendance for that. That was kind of a big deal for him, his second career Cup win. Pack number three, let's see what it bears us. We have J.J. Yaley, who does drive for Rick Ware Motorsports. This looks like an Xfinity uniform for JGL Racing, who is no longer in the sport. I believe their owner ended up having some health issues. Ryan Newman during his time at Childers. Of course, Ryan currently drives for Roush. His plans for 2022, currently unknown at this time. Looks like we have a filler card there. We have Dale Earnhardt Jr., who is in the NBC broadcast booth and also owns some Xfinity teams. There's our little filler card. Martin Truex Jr. and Kyle Busch. So we end this pack with a couple of current JGR teammates. Since that pack's thick, we're going to open it last. Maybe save some good stuff for the end. Being a hobby box, it's hard to tell. It can be dynamite or it can just be a dud. We'll wait and see. Carl Edwards, of course, he was racing for Joe Gibbs at this time. This car is currently driven by Martin Truex Jr. We have a rookie card of Brandon Jones. We have a red numbered card coming up. It's Greg Biffle. Ooh, it is an autograph of the Biff. Oh man, we were one off of a door number. That is kind of depressing. 15 out of 199. We almost hit a door number, guys. That'd been pretty sweet. But Greg Biffle, during his time, of course, at Roush, where he spent almost his entire Cup career, almost his entire NASCAR career. Greg has won a then Busch Series championship. He also won a Truck Series championship. And he's finished at a tie for second in Cup Series points. So that's the closest anybody has come to winning all three national championships. Tyler Reddick. And again, this is not listed as a rookie card, but I'm going to consider it a rookie card because 2016 was his first releases. This is when he was driving for Brad Keselowski in the Truck Series. Of course, he drives for Childress now. And we have Tony Stewart. No introduction needed here. We all know who that man is. Now we're going to go to our final pack of the day. Final pack of this box. Probably need to buy more of this product. I really like it. I mean, you get four hits basically per box. Maybe five. I don't really recall. But we're going to shuffle this hit to the back. And I can feel it's a relic, but I don't think it's going to be anything spectacular. Colin Cabret. We seem to get Mr. Cabret in almost every one of our boxes of Panini product. And then we have Dave Marcus. Pulled an autograph of him the other day. It's a pretty nice looking card. And another immortal back-to-back, Harry Gant, during his time as the Skull Bandit. Looking at this picture, I'm going to guess this is probably 1984 or 85, based on the helmet and just that stripe right above the door. Casey Kane, during one of his last seasons at Hendrick Motorsports. And we're already to our hit card. So not sure which direction we need to go. It looks like it's a, is it a sideways guy? It is a sideways guy, and it's somebody with a forehead. Who do we know with a forehead? Oh, wow, Kyle Busch. A quad relic numbered 62 out of 75. So it looks like you got uniform, tire. Is that uniform? That's tire, and sheet metal. So again, I apologize for the screen being a little bit dark. It's just because it's bright in here, and I really can't do anything to make it better. I'm going to eventually invest in me one of those ring lights or something to give me a little bit more pop here. But we got that nice Mark Martin numbered card. Then we got the Kyle Busch relic and a Greg Biffle autograph. That was one off of the door number. That was pretty impressive there. So hope you guys enjoyed today's video. It's a lot of fun finishing off this hobby box. You know we'll get more here. And we'll probably do some more driver review videos. I got my list off here to the side. It's the folks that have requested driver videos. Just got to work on getting those sorted. Maybe I'll have a little bit of time this weekend and we can knock a couple of those out for you guys. So anyway, I appreciate you guys hanging in there, watching these videos, liking, commenting, and of course subscribing. We're working our way up in terms of number of subscriptions. But, you know, I don't know how what we're going to do and what direction we're going to go with, you know, growing the channel a little bit bigger as we get more folks involved. So, as always, I appreciate everything. Thanks for everything that you guys do. We will see you again tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of your Tuesday.